While Jean-Baptiste Say did not use these exact words in 1803, the main idea behind Say's law is that supply creates its own demand, or in other words, you cannot buy without having something to sell. If John takes care of 5 chicken and Bill has 7 apple trees, then John has to have eggs to sell if he wants to obtain apples, either through barter or by selling eggs for money and using that money to buy apples from Bill. Fair enough so far, right? Or you can think of a very simplified virtuous circle where firms produce goods by paying wages and rent, whereas employees and landowners use that money to buy products from firms. Again, sounds perfectly logical. Unfortunately, Say's law is quite rigid because according to it, aggregate supply equals aggregate demand, or to simplify, the total supply of goods and services will be equal to the total demand for goods and services. However, humans are complex and frequently emotion-driven beings. As situations like the Great Depression of 1929 prove, we sometimes become frightened. As such, demand for goods and services drops because people just keep money under the proverbial mattress, which results in a deflationary spiral where there's too much supply and not enough demand, a situation which can persist for quite a while. Therefore, some economists, like John Maynard Keynes, believe governments need to step in and create demand themselves. The opposite of Say's law, if you will. Other economic thinkers, Austrian economists for example, believe that in a world without government and central bank involvement in the economy, Say's law would be valid. At this point, honestly, we just don't know.